Welcome to DevOps Omniscience with JFrog Xray webinar. For audio quality purposes, everybody would be on mute today. There would be a Q&A tab where you can put up your questions and we would be answering those questions after this webinar. The questions unanswered would be answered through the follow-up email when this webinar would be completed. So let's go ahead and start the JFrog Xray webinar. So I'm the speaker today, Mansimran Singh, working as a solution engineer at JFrog, part of the solution engineering team, working with more than 3,000 customers, integrating Artifactory and Xray into their architectures. So before I go ahead and start the webinar and discuss the features of Xray and how it works with Artifactory, there's a very brief poll in order to understand what sort of audience we are having today. And the questions which we are having in the poll is, are you familiar with Artifactory? And what topics would you like to see in our future webinars? So I'm just going to launch this poll. And the poll would be there on your screens. So we would give a minute in order for people to vote on the options given over there. That is, that how familiar are you with Artifactory? And what topics you would like to see in the future webinars? Great, I'm getting some inputs. So I can see that some people are opting for, they have used the Artifactory at the very basic level. Okay, so let me share the results with you. So as you can see that most of the people have either used at the very basic level or either they are the experienced. So we have almost 50% of the people who have used at a basic level and 50% of people who are admins of the Artifactory. And you would like to see how JFrog Artifactory works for the DevOps in the, as a future webinar. Definitely we would take this thing into the consideration and we would come up some new webinar advanced topics as well. So let's go ahead and see that how Xray works with Artifactory and how it actually protects all your binaries. So in this slide, you can see that there are four products of JFrog. One is called as Artifactory, which is a flagship product, then Mission Control, Xray, and Bintray. All the four products work together and provide you an ecosystem where you can integrate your binaries into your architectures, and Artifactory is a central piece over there. And Xray works very closely with Artifactory in order to scan all those binaries which are coming inside the organization. Now, in the next slide, let's try to understand how binaries actually come inside the organization and how Artifactory and Xray works together in order to protect them according to the organizational policies. Of course, everything starts with the development team writing the new code. And when they write the new code, they basically add the new dependencies that the binary repository or artifact repositories care about. And that can be a new dependency in the form of pom.xml, Gradle script, IVXML, gem config file, or any kind of dependency. Now over there, when the developers declare these dependencies, basically they are not aware that the dependency I'm declaring would be a vulnerable one. Is it safe to use or not? So let's see that how this process goes on. Now, as soon as they declare this dependency, of course, before they run the build, they would be getting these dependencies from the local Artifactory. Now, as soon as they get these binaries from the local Artifactory, you can see there's Xray, which is going to trigger in, and it's going to scan each and everything which is there inside Artifactory. So automatically, whatever is inside your organization that has already been scanned by Xray, and you would automatically get a protected binary over there. But in another case, when those dependencies are not there in the local repository, in this case, Artifactory is going to fetch those dependencies, or it's going to resolve those dependencies from the remote repositories like JCenter or Maven Center for Java, NPM Registry, Docker Hub, NuGet Gallery, etc., etc. Now, this is a very critical point. because nobody knows that if you're getting these libraries from outside, are they safe to use or not? And again, Xray and Artifactory is there to help you over there. As soon as a dependency is brought from outside and it's cached inside Artifactory, again, Xray is going to trigger in, and it's going to scan each and every binary over there in order to scan for all the security vulnerabilities, in order to scan all the license compliance issues. And if there is anything which is having a vulnerability inside it, Xray is going to scan and alert you that, hey, you tried to download a binary from some remote repo, and here is a list of the vulnerabilities which I found over there, up to the organization policies, whether you want to block the download of that particular dependency, or you want to allow it into an isolated repo, or any other things. Assuming that you got all your binaries and everything is working fine, you basically commit the changes to the source control, and in the next step, the continuous integration server kicks in. Now, it discovers the changes in the version control by polling, of course, and takes the changes and tries to run the same exact build that the developer was running on their machine. And this time, the CA server will actually look for the dependencies in the Artifactory instead of going anywhere else. The good news is that those dependencies will be found instantly because they were already pre-cached by the developer when the developer had run the local build. And it's very safe to assume that since the developer had run the local build through Artifactory, which was integrated with Xray, that build was very, very safe to use inside the organization. And this time, when the CA server is also triggering in, it's going to follow the same process. Now, you can see that CA server had actually resolved the dependencies from Artifactory, which were already scanned by Xray in the last process, and they all were safe to use as well. Now, once the build is successful, the CA server will deploy the artifacts to the Artifactory, and along with it, it will also deploy what we call as the build of materials. This build of material is extremely important because it contains the metadata about the build. Another source of metadata which might be of equal importance is the quality assurance data, which is captured from tools like Selenium, Cucumber, etc., etc. All these can contribute towards the metadata on the artifact as well. And all this information which is preserved in the form of metadata actually helps you in order to use these binaries in a very safer way. In the next step, artifacts that need to go to the production will be actually selected from all the artifacts that were ever built. And here we have the two different ways to take the artifacts to the production. Now, again, over here as well, Xray is going to trigger in. And as soon as you tell any of your provisioning tools to pick up the binaries which are to be used in the production, you can safely assume that these were scanned by the Xray and these are safer to use in the production environments. Now, let's go a step back and try to understand if Xray is not there. Now, if you are working on a system and you already had used the binaries which are vulnerable, and you have used those binaries in the production servers as well, and after some time, you feel like, hey, I found a vulnerability which is there in the production systems, and that's actually affecting a lot of things, there is quite a loss over there in order to fix those things. And if Xray was there in the very beginning, all the process was very smoothly carried on, right from the step when the developer was working on it, to the step where CI server was triggering in, and towards the last step when you were putting up these binaries in your production systems. Now, as I was explaining that there are two ways in order to deploy your software. The first one, if you are having the services more like SaaS that is deployable to your servers, tools like Chef, Puppet, Ansible, Vagrant, etc., etc. will kick in and get the artifacts from Artifactory and would deploy to the production servers. Now, if your software is something which is more like downloadable software, then of course distribution platform like WinRay would be a better choice. And over here, you can distribute these binaries to your external customers or to the external machines. And over here also, it's always safer to use Xray because you want to distribute the safer binaries to your customers. Since we were talking a lot about customers, there is a motivation behind when we designed the Xray. So since Artifactory were being used by more than 3,000 customers, we asked our customers to guide us when we were developing Xray in order to get the feedback, what exactly the pain points are being faced by them. So they told us that your build info feature is great, It's having actually a lot of information, what is being consumed along with their checksums, what are the dependencies, what are the versions and all the stuff. But we need more insights if we can get the report about whether is it safe to use these binaries or not. And they also needed some external metadata for the open source components in terms of security vulnerabilities, out of date versioning issues, and of course the license compliance issues as well. Now, there are more than like 90 licenses which are being used inside organizations. Some are being vulnerable, some are being not vulnerable, and some are being blacklisted by the organization, some are being allowed. So over here, you clear-cut need to define the policy, what is being accepted, and only those things which are compliant with organization policies come inside, and anything which is not compliant would be rejected right away in the artifactory. Apart from that, when you put up a new system, there are some architectural issues which only your teams know, only your security architects know. And you can basically set up these things inside a database that if anything is coming inside, it should not be affecting the architecture, it should not be affecting the performance. So all these things are being recorded in Xray as well. Another important thing which is to be mentioned over here is that softwares are no more homogeneous. Consider the example of Docker. Nobody ships the empty containers. Docker is having something in it. So when we say Docker is having something in it, basically you are shipping some artifacts of different technologies. For example, you could be putting up a Debian file inside a Docker image. This Debian file could be having a war file. This war file could be having a jar file, etc., etc. Now, when we have these heterogeneous mixtures, it becomes much more complex in order to learn more about them, in order to scan them, in order to extract the information out of them than what is exactly lying inside. And to cover this, this is the component graph which Xray makes out of your artifactory, and these are the packages being consumed over there. Now let's try to understand how this component graph is made out of all this. Consider this example. And we have this larger box, consider this larger box as a vagrant box. And inside this vagrant box, I might be having a Docker image. Inside the Docker image, I might be having a Debian file. And inside this Debian file, I might be having a war file. And inside that war file, I might be having a jar file, which might be having some more jar files inside. So you can see that there are many, many layers associated lying on top of them. Now, as soon as this vagrant box is pushed inside Artifactory, Xray is going to trigger in. And you can see that there is a direct relationship between Artifactory and Xray. Now, as soon as this vagrant box is there in Artifactory, Xray is going to peel off each and every layer, scanning each and every artifact which is lying within it. And in the end, it's going to scan each and every component and it's going to be making a component graph out of it. For example, if the last layer, that's a jar file, is having a vulnerability associated with it, or there is any custom issue associated with it, it's going to make a component graph which would list that, hey, if you're consuming this particular jar file in many other vagrant boxes, in many other Docker images, all those components are being affected as well, not just a particular box. And you can see that you can include all this information, external vulnerability providers, any profiling issues, for example, performance or runtime bugs, any architecture issues or any security issues. And in the end, Xray is going to submit its report with the help of an email or with a chatbot, or you can also integrate the webhooks like Jira to automatically log a Jira when there's an issue about it. Now, when this scanning is completed, of course, apart from the reporting, Xray is also going to put this metadata right back inside Artifactory, so that anytime you want to see that what was happening over there, you can basically run a report on top of your Artifactory as well. For example, you can run an AQL that's called as Artifactory Query Language, and you can define the parameters. Hey, give me all the artifacts which were scanned 100 days back, which are having the security vulnerabilities minor or major or critical and above, and they were deployed by some particular user. And in the end, AQL is going to generate a report for you And based on that report, you can take some further mitigation measures, like you can basically clean up all these artifacts, or you can move all those artifacts into an isolated repository where the architects review all those artifacts, and then they basically promote the artifacts based upon their decisions. There are some background tasks which Xray is always working on. For example, indexing. Now, as I said that, it's very important to learn about the component graph, which Xray make out of your artifacts. And in order to understand about what is being consumed where and what all things are being affected, a continuous indexing goes on behind the scenes. And indexing means Xray is always working in order to learn more about what is used in what part of the artifacts. Of course, with the help of the push notifications, you can update your database from the metadata sources. And of course, there you can set up your own custom database as well. And with the help of all these things, you can have more information about the issues. And the way Xray works is it always watches the artifacts inside your artifact tree, apart from the indexing, which is going on behind the scenes. And you can define the watchers based upon some criteria. For example, as a new issue or a content is discovered inside artifact tree, alerts are immediately triggered based upon the function or based upon the filter you provide over there. There's an also on-demand artifact scan. You can basically go inside Xray and you can basically trigger manual scan on any of the artifact or any of the repository or any of the build you want to. And in the end, of course, you can do the impact analysis, that what is being consumed where, and if I'm having an issue inside one of the components, what is the impact on all the other components as well. And in terms of getting the reports, which was of course through email and chatbots and like webhooks, you would be getting a report on the issue showing that what artifact was scanned, how many artifacts were scanned, how many are having the issues, and what severity level they are having over there as well. Apart from that, you would be also able to see a report based upon the deep scan showing all the impacted issues as well. And in terms of alerts, we have already seen that it's with the form of email or webhooks or chatbots. Now, release fast or die, that's the tagline of our company, and that's being applicable to each and every software company in the world as well. Because of the competition and because of the issues which the organizations are facing, releasing fast or releasing your build processes fast becomes very important. And the way you can do is only with the help of continuous indexing or continuous determination. And this term is specially developed for Xray, what we call as CI/CD. And that's continuous indexing and continuous determination. Now, it's available on deploy. It's available during a CI/CD processes. For example, as soon as you trigger your builds, your artifacts start scanning, and whenever they are in production, you can scan them as well. The big point is the universal nature of Xray as well as artifact tree. Now, the same principle of artifact tree, that's a universal compatibility, that's being provided into Xray as well. And it works with majority of packages, which are also shown in this slide. And there are many, many more to come as well. And Artifactory provides a notification to the Xray of these new packages, and Xray pulls out to the initiate indexing as well. Of course, there is not just one way where we can gather the information. Now, there are different ways to scan the artifacts. Of course, the one is you can use the UI of the Xray. But apart from that, this is not the way everything would be working. The machines also triggers in order to scan the artifacts. Everything is done in an automated way. So we have the REST APIs, which are fully documented and stable, and they can be used with all the other tools where they can automatically pick up the artifacts which have been scanned by Xray. They can also tell the Xray to manually scan the components which are triggering in. And of course, all this metadata is being captured inside Artifactory for your further reporting or your further use as well. Now, the important question arises is that what are the ways by which we are discovering the vulnerabilities? And the very important thing is we are referring to what we call as an internal public source database, which is NVD, that's National Vulnerability Database. Apart from that, we have some partner integrations with WideSource and Aqua, and some other integrations are also pending. But the third option is you can also set up your custom database where you can put up your proprietary information, which only your organization is having with you. And the advantage is that you don't need to expose this information anywhere else. This would be completely and completely isolated from the rest of the world. And anytime you scan an artifact, it's basically going to compare against multiple databases. And of course, the more the information, more the security. Enough talking, let's see how this actually works. Now, let me go to the Xray first. Let me see, somebody has sent me a question. Okay, so I would address that question with somebody has sent me in the chat as well. So this is Xray. And this is the latest version of Xray, that's 1.1.1. And on the home page, you can see that there are some shortcuts. For example, how many Artifactory instances are being connected to Xray, how many component graphs have been indexed, and how many alerts have already been sent. Now, in order to integrate an Artifactory instance with Xray, you just need to click on the new instance button, provide your Artifactory ID, any name which you would like to give, the URL of Artifactory, the admin user and password. And just for the demo purposes, I already have one of the Artifactory instances being connected to it. You can see I have provided the Artifactory ID, the URL, and in my right-hand side, you can see the artifact repositories which are being scanned through Xray or which are being indexed right now. Over here, you can see how many components have been indexed, and anytime the Xray is going to provide you the results, then how many artifacts are there in that particular repository and how many have been automatically indexed by now. You can also filter the repositories by giving up a name. For example, you can see that I would be scanning a repository which is named as Test with War. It is a Maven repository. If I just calculate, there are two packages and they have been indexed as well. Now, if I click on this particular button, it's going to give you a pop-up box which is going to give you an option to delete or to add the repositories which are being indexed through Xray. And it's a very, very easy process as well. And this process is also available inside Artifactory as well as Xray. Great, this was all about integrating Artifactory with Xray. And another important thing which somebody pinged me during this chat as well, that we are exposing the information outside. No, we are not exposing. You would be getting the definitions from our central Xray database to your internal database, and you have the two options. You can update your database offline, as well as you can sync your database with the help of database syncing option. So you can see that there's an online, there is an offline option as well. In the online option, Xray is going to update its database automatically. And in the offline button, you can basically download the definitions by providing a date range, or you can get a complete zip file from our central database, and then you can update your internal database without exposing any information outside. And the way, as I was explaining you, you start by watching the artifacts in the Artifactory, and I have a demo set up over here, which I'm showing you is, you can set up a watcher by clicking the new button that's over here. You need to provide the details, which I'm having in the already set up watcher. So that's, you provide the name, you provide the target type, you have the three options. You can also watch a build, you can watch a repository, or you can watch each and every artifact inside the Artifactory. I'm just selecting a repository right now. Over here, you would be providing your Artifactory instances. Just for your reference, you can attach multiple Artifactory instances to a single instance of Artifactory. Single instance of Xray. And in the dropdown, you would be able to see all the options. Since I'm having only one instance of Artifactory connected to the Xray, so I'm only getting the one option. And over here, automatically it picks up the repositories. And since I would be scanning a Docker image, so I'm actually having a Docker repository associated with it. In the notifications, you can add the emails or you can add the webhooks. I'm just adding my email over here. And on top of a repository, you can basically apply many, many other filters as well. For example, you can apply any regex pattern. You can select a package type. You can select a MIME type. You can select any particular build, or you can select any particular property. And the way it works is you can define the key value pairs over here. And I have selected a component which is called as band licenses. I can show you. So you have the two other options of allowed licenses. So as soon as the artifacts comes inside artifact tree, it's going to trigger in and it's going to tell you that these are the allowed licenses inside your organization. And here is the report of the licenses which are being consumed, apart from the licenses which could be banned as well. Now, as soon as I click the plus button, I can select the licenses which are banned inside the organization. I'm selecting MIT, which is not a very good example. But since this is the license I have associated with an artifact, so I'm going to scan an artifact against this particular license as well. Great, my watcher has been set up. And if I now go inside Artifactory, inside the artifacts, you can see this is the repository which we have associated with Xray. And right now I'm having only two images inside this particular folder. I'm going to push the third one. And as soon as this particular thing is pushed inside Artifactory, Xray is going to trigger in and it's going to be sending me an alert about its report. Now, let me go to my console. I'm going to by the size. So I'm going to build a Docker image. So you can see that Docker image is being made and I actually downloaded a WAR file which is having this particular license associated with it. Now I'm going to push this particular Docker image inside Artifactory. Great, the image is pushed. And if I just refresh this folder, you can see the image is over here. And if I go into the properties, you can see the status is pending. That means Xray has triggered in and it's working behind the scenes. And this status is going to change with the status as scan. And it's going to update the results over here as well, that what was the issue found over there, what is the severity of that issue and all the stuff. Let me refresh this. Okay, it's still in the pending state. So it would take some time to scan this particular Docker image and this might be having some components inside it. And as I said, as soon as this particular thing is completed, I'm going to get an email alert. So let me go, okay. So if I refresh this, I got an alert in the Xray. So you can see that Xray has completed its scanning. The status has been changed to scan. It updated some of the things over here. For example, what's the SHA-256 of that particular image? What is the repo name? This is the severity which I found over there, and that's a critical one. This is the repository which is having that particular image associated with it. And now if I go into the Xray and I go into the alerts tab, I would be able to see that there was this particular watcher which was being watched inside the Xray. And if I click on it, I'm going to see the information about that particular license. And over here is the information that this particular image is having that particular web jar which is having the MIT license associated with it. And apart from that, I have also associated a custom issue, which I was explaining that only my organization knows about it. And inside your organization, only your security teams would be knowing about these issues. And these issues can be varied. For example, it's an architecture issue, it's a performance issue, it's a security issue, or any other third issue as well. And the way Component Graph is made out of all this is that now if you go inside components, I look for test with war. So you can see all, I can pick any of the components. This was a Docker image inside this layer. There was a var file inside this var file. There was a jar file which was having an issue. It is of type Maven. This is the version number which is being associated with it. And you can see the more information about the versioning. For example, a latest version has been released on this particular date, and that's 1.2. You can also get the latest version in order to get rid of this issue as well. And if I want to see more details about this, is that you can click on the view component details. That's the same one. And there's a custom issue also associated with this particular jar file. And now I can also define another issue, which might be my performance team or might be my other teams have discovered during their testing. So I can say issue demo. This is a issue found during webinar. And over here, you can associate a severity with it. I would say it's a major level issue. And the type is either it's a security issue, it's a versioning issue, it's a performance issue. So I would say it's a versioning issue. And you can add some properties to it. And if I click the save button, you can see an alert is created telling me that now this issue is being associated with this particular jar file. And you can see how the Xray gives you details about that particular Docker image. Inside that Docker image, there was a layer. Inside that layer, there was a var file. And inside that var file, there was a jar file, which was having this issue. And since the Xray is having the capability to do the deep indexing, now this particular jar file is being consumed into many, many other Docker images as well. And on my left-hand side, you can see all the impacted components which are using this particular jar file, and they all are being shown over here. This is kind of most important thing, because it's great that I can discover an issue in one of the Docker images, but as I said, that what if hundreds and thousands of other things are being impacted because of an issue over here? And you can also get the issue detail over here as well. So you can see component details, and if you click on the ancestors, you can see these are the ancestors which are being affected as well. So this var file was being consumed into this layer, and this particular layer is being consumed into all these Docker images as well. So this becomes very, very important, because I might be having the information about one of the components, but I might not be having the information about all the components which have been affected of all this. Great, so far, everything is going good. Xray did the scanning. It provided me the alert showing that, hey, I found the issues over here. But what about after this? How I'm going to make the users to block the download of these artifacts? How I'm going to stop them that they should not be using the issues with the vulnerabilities? So over here, Artifactory is going to help you. Now, since if I go into the general tab, over here you would be able to see a critical tab. And if I go into the configuration of this repository, you would be able to see that I have basically blocked all the unscanned artifacts as well as the artifacts which are having the severity level major and above. Now, important thing is that I don't want my developers or I don't want my users to download any artifact which has not been scanned through Xray. And any unscanned artifact would be having an vulnerability associated with it. And if I go back into my repository, that's Docker Dev Local, I pick up any unscanned artifacts. That's a very, very known thing, Hello World image. And you can see that this is an unscanned artifact, and Xray is going to give you a warning that this artifact is currently blocked for download until it has been indexed and scanned by Xray. Please try again once processing is completed. And important thing is that there is no download button over here. And this download button is only available when this Xray completes its scanning and gives its report over there. Now, since there is no download button on the UI, but as a user, I can try to download it from my console. So let's try that as well. So I'm just trying to pull the same image which I had shown you over here. That's Docker hello tag number 51. So I'm just using the same thing, Docker hello tag 51. As soon as I try to pull up this image, it says that image not found. And if I go into my logs, it says that try to fetch a Docker image. Let me modify the size. So you can see that clearly the logs say that it was not downloaded due to the download blocking policy configured in the Docker dev local. The artifact may be available for downloading once it has been scanned and indexed by Xray. The same is available for the scanned artifacts which are being having the vulnerabilities associated with them. And since we have already set up that anything which is minor or major or above should be blocked as well. And the same functionality would be available to your users as well when they would try to download any artifact which is having a vulnerability associated with it. This was great up till now. Now, how I'm going to be making sure that my build processes are also following this protocol. Now, as soon as you associate your CI servers to work with Artifactory, their build is also going to fail because the download is not going to happen. And it's in the logs, it's going to be showing that you were not able to run this particular build because as per the organizational policies, these artifacts were scanned because they were having some vulnerabilities associated with them, or they were not at all scanned by Xray. Great. So this was all about the integration of Xray as well as Artifactory. And if I go back into the Xray, if I go into the alerts, you can see the custom issue which I had been running over there. And you similarly, you can define some other issues as well. If you're running a build again and again, you can ignore this issue. And the next time it's going to do the scanning, it's not going to give you this particular warning because it already knows that I have already sent this warning once. So next time the user doesn't need to know that what is going on behind the scenes. Apart from this, if you go into the admin tab, since we have some partner integrations, you can add your white source licensing information over here, as well as your acquire licensing information over here. At any time, Xray is going to scan a new artifact. It's going to scan against multiple databases for your custom issues, the database against the NVD, as well as the databases which are being provided to you with the partner integrations from white source and Aqua. And you can also register a trial license. You can set up the mails, users, webhooks. Everything is available in the admin tab. And in the component tab, you can get the component graph. In the alerts, you would be getting the alerts. In the watcher, you can set up the watches. And on the home page, you would be getting all these details with the help of the shortcuts available to the Xray. So I would be taking up the questions now. And you can put up your questions in the Q&A tab. So let me see if there are any questions. Okay, so one of the questions I got is, how are we getting the information about the vulnerabilities? So we are basically comparing the checksum of each and every artifact with the checksums against NVD. And as soon as a checksum is matched over there, Xray does know that this is this particular jar, this particular ward, this particular component, this particular artifact is having a vulnerability. And that's the way we map that information inside Xray. Another question. So how does Xray recognize the jars and the wards? So Artifactory is having this feature inside it. As soon as you push any ward file, it's going to explode that ward file into a jar file. And if you want to see a demo, I can provide you a demo over here. If you go inside any of the repository, and if I click the deploy button, I select a file. This is a war file. As soon as you deploy a war file, it automatically extracts the information out of it that this was a war file, and it's going to explode that war file into a jar file, which was having the information about it. So this is the way the Xray extract the information from Artifactory, and this is the way Xray is going to know that what war file is having what jar file and which jar file is having an issue as well. Okay. And another question in the tab. can I have different download policies in different directories within the same repository? Right now, this feature only works as a whole on the complete repository. You cannot define the different policies for the download on the different folders, but we can provide this feedback and we can have this feature available in the next versions of the Xray, where you can have the different policies depending upon the different paths you provide in each and every configuration over there. But right now, this feature works on a repository and not on the folder level. So somebody asked me that how many Artifactory instances can be connected to a single instance of Xray. You can connect multiple Artifactory instances. I don't have the exact number right now with me. It all depends upon the load which Xray can handle. It all depends upon the size and machine configurations which you provide to it. Depending upon those things, you can provide multiple Artifactory instances to a single instance of Xray as well. Now the question is there that do you provide the license for the partner integrations or you have to buy the license on your own? So you have to buy the license on your own for the partner integrations. It's just that the integration is there out of the box. You don't need to take the manual efforts in order to set up the REST APIs or any other tooling configuration. You just need to provide your API key for the byte source and API key and the URL for your Aqua, and everything would be taken care of inside the Xray. Is Xray accessible from Mission Center? It's not Mission Center, it's Mission Control. We are working on the integration for Xray with Mission Control, but in the current preview version of Mission Control, the Xray feature is not available over there. But that's a good suggestion. We are definitely working on it, and we would be coming up with something which can be controlled from Mission Control, all your Artifactory instances, as well as the Xray instances as well. So another question is that, how can I configure a watcher to watch any artifact based upon the properties? So I had shown you this, the same thing while setting up a watcher, but I can do that again. As soon as you click on the new button, you can provide the name of the watcher. You can provide the target as a repository. You provide the repository name. As I said, that I'm just selecting the Docker Dev local, and you go over here and you provide a filter type as property. You click on it, you provide as demo webinar, and you can apply multiple properties, not a problem. You can add as many properties as you want, and as soon as a property is put on an artifact inside Artifactory, for example, if I pick up the same Docker image, as soon as you put up a property over here, it's going to simply trigger the Xray that, hey, I found this particular property demo webinar on it. Now please scan this particular thing for the users, and it's going to give you the details about that particular thing as well. And properties concept, as I said, it becomes very, very important because you can run many, many automations around it. For example, in future, you might say that, hey, give me all the artifacts which are indexed by Xray on a particular date, which were deployed by a particular user, which are 100 days old, which are having a severity level minor or above, and all this stuff. All these things are being stored in the database, and your query turns out to be a database query, and your results are returned very, very fast in a JSON format, and then you can run your log parsers or JQ parsers on top of it to extract all the information that any point of time I'm having probably 50,000 artifacts in my Artifactory. And out of the 50,000 artifacts, probably 100 or 200 are the vulnerable one. These are their checksums. This is the report generated out of it. And basically, your security teams can review those things as well. I got another question. We use permission target to control the access. It might be good to link the Xray policy to the permission target. Yes, we are again working on integrating the Xray permission targets into, the Artifactory permission targets into the Xray permission targets. You would be, in the future versions, you would be also able to hook up your LDAP or SSO or the other things which are available inside Artifactory. They are going to be available with the Xray as well, so that there is no more need to put up the manual users into the Xray. You would be able to import all your users and each and everything from your LDAP servers or SSO configurations or OAuth parameters and each and everything. Okay. Another question which is coming up over here is, does Xray support HA? Right now in this version, we are not supporting HA, but based upon the user feedback and based upon the customer feedback, we can design an HA for Xray as well. Since HA for Artifactory is already available, you can have an HA for the Xray in the future versions available as well. Okay, so if you're not having any more questions for me, it's time to finish up this webinar. You are more than welcome to join our other webinar series as well. And that is usually happening on the every Tuesday, the Artifactory webinar series. We start with the introduction to JFrog on the first Tuesday, the pro version on the second Tuesday, and the enterprise features and enterprise use cases on the third Tuesday. On every Thursday, we have lunch and learn program where we cover up the advanced topics or the advanced automation topics. And we also have some special webinars which we do with our partners from time to time. And they happen on Wednesdays as well as Thursdays. You can get all the information on jfrog.com/webinars. You can register for all these webinars and you would be getting the reminder for these webinars on the day when it's going to happen. Thank you, everyone. If you have any more questions, please feel free to send these questions to webinars@jfrog.com. And one of our solution engineers will be more than happy to answer all those questions for you. Have a nice day. Thank you for joining.